welcome to my kitchen and another installment of Chat and Channel Update. Today we're here to just notify you of the winners of our Fireside Gourmet giveaway from 2 weeks ago. We had that open until yesterday, and I went ahead and I drew the names. The winners have been notified, and to those of you who have won, congratulations. You're going to receive one package of two grilling mats that you can go ahead and give a try at home. I hope you enjoy them. We're enjoying them. We had a lot of fun showing you how to use them, and Fireside Gourmet was very generous to be able to give us five sets to give away, and the winners are Ruby, Michelle Riggio, Lily Ferris, Eric, and it's E.R. Sposito is the name on his email, and then Donna Ranella Seiler. So congratulations to all of you folks. Thank you so much for participating, and thank you for being an important part of our Noreen's Kitchen community. Not really much to update you on. I am currently very busy. I am working on a new cookbook, which I hope will be released at the end of October. It will be a dinner cookbook. It's going to have a lot of different dinner ideas in it. Working title is currently Noreen's Kitchen, What's for Dinner Weeknight Wonders. I don't know if that's going to be the final title. It's going to be a smaller format cookbook. Instead of being a large 8.5 by 11, it's going to be a smaller 5.5 by 8.5 style program kind of size. If you go to your kids' concerts and stuff, you get the piece of paper folded in half. But it'll be spiral bound, and there will be an e-version available. And when I get that published and released, then I'll probably be using that opportunity to do a giveaway on that cookbook as well. So I'm excited about that. Don't forget, I also have two other cookbooks, Noreen's Kitchen Holiday Helper and Noreen's Kitchen Cocos and Cookies and More Galore, and that one came out last year. The one other one came out 2 years ago. Those are available. You can go to my website, or you can go down below in the information box, and you can get taken to wherever it is you need to go, which is through lulu.com. If you have suggestions for my next cookbook, I actually had enough recipes for two cookbooks this time, so I'm hoping that in about 3 months I'll probably be releasing yet another one. So that's my goal, is to start releasing smaller, more usable cookbooks more often, and also to have like cookbooklets eventually, where I'm going to be having smaller cookbooklets that don't have like a ton of recipes in them, maybe just 25 or 30, and then have it on a smaller, much more affordable format. So that's kind of where I'm at with that. I've been kicking around a lot of different things, and I've been doing a lot of different research and a lot of recipe development at my end recently. With the cooler weather, of course, that always gets me more motivated. You all know I hate the summer, and it's very difficult for me to get through the summer for any number of reasons. But I really do see great things on the horizon. I would like to take a moment to say congratulations to fellow YouTube foodie Laura Vitale for the premiere of her cooking show on the Cooking Channel. You know, a victory for one YouTuber is a victory for all YouTubers, and I think especially for those of us in the cooking community, I think it is super important that we hold each other up and we support each other. And if you haven't checked out Laura, I highly suggest that you do. Her show is called Simply Laura. It's on the Cooking Channel every Saturday morning or afternoon at 1:30 Eastern Time, which would be 10:30 Pacific? I don't know. Yeah, 10:30 Pacific. But I watched the first episode yesterday. It was beautiful. The cinematography is wonderful. The feel is great. And it's really very much her. And I couldn't be happier for her. And I hope you'll all join me in just sending a great big virtual hug over to Laura and her husband Joe, because I know they've worked hard and they deserve this milestone in their life. So congratulations. And gosh, the garden, let's not even go there. We've been working on holiday items on our garden channel. Last week we did garlic-infused oil. The week before we did chili-infused vinegar. This week I'm going to be showing you how to make a botanical wreath with some of the herbs that are coming out of the garden that we don't want to waste. lots of rosemary, etc., that's coming out. Still an evergreen kind of thing, so I thought it might be fun to put a wreath together and show you how I do that. For those of you who may not know, I spent a number of years being a florist, actually owned my own flower shop, and I did a lot of floral work for a number of years. I was also a paralegal. I was also a journalist. I've been a lot of things. I have a lot of things to a lot of people, as I'm sure you are. But anyway, so that's what's going on over at the Garden Channel. Rick's channel, of course, every little thing that presents itself, we just open the camera up and we start filming. So you can see how I fixed my mixer. Yes, there's always something. That's the truth. I do promise you that it was my goal to have the crafting channel up and running at the beginning of October, and that is still the plan. There is someone behind the camera who has to do something very important for me before I actually do some filming for that channel, but that is coming. He actually has to make me a camera boom so that I have something that will hold the camera over my workspace so you can actually see what I'm doing. And that is in the works right now. So, trying to think what else without making this video far too long. I just guess I want to say thank you. I really enjoy doing what I'm doing, and I'm so glad that you're here and joining me for the ride. I love all the feedback that I get for the most part from all of you folks, and it's always so constructive, and it's always so informative. I get so many great ideas from you, and I hope that you'll continue to give me ideas. I get personal messages all the time. Last week, we shared a recipe on how to make a Black Forest cake. Someone had said, I'm going to a potluck, and I want to take it, so I made it up, and they were super happy. If there are things that you might like to see me do, that you like to see how I do them, please send me a note, drop me a line, send me an email, a private message, put it in the comment section. I do pay attention. Even though I may not answer everybody all the time, I do pay attention when you make comments and suggestions, and I actually do write them down in a real book with a real pen on real paper. So just know that I do take all of that into consideration when I'm developing and when I'm making lists. So I guess that's really where we're going to stop today. I hope that you have a fantastic week, and I hope that you do what makes you happy. So until next time, I'll see ya. Thank you for joining me in my kitchen today. I hope you liked what you watched today, and I hope that you try it, and I hope that you love it. If you like what you saw, please consider hitting the thumbs up button and giving me a positive rating. And also, make sure that you hit the subscribe button if you're already not a subscriber, so that you don't miss out on any of the fun we have here in our kitchen every single day. I hope that you enjoyed it. I'm really glad that you're here. Thank you for stopping by. Don't forget to come by tomorrow. Until next time, happy eating!